Hi, in this video I'd like to talk about where you can get or how you can make your own HID Remapper. HID Remapper is a universal adapter for USB input devices. It comes in many shapes and sizes. Which one you go for will depend on your individual needs and whether or not you're willing to do some soldering. There are three main options. Option 1 is to just buy one of the boards that are on the market that can be used as an HID Remapper directly. Option 2 is to make your own using a Raspberry Pi Pico or 2. Option 3 is to have a custom PCB manufactured for you by a company in China. Let's go over each option in detail. Option 1 is the simplest one. If you don't have any specific needs and one of these boards is available to you, just get it and you're done. Currently, I'm aware of two products that can be used as an HID Remapper directly. One is the Adafruit Feather RP2040 with USB Type-A host. As you can see, it has two USB ports. You use the Type-C port to connect it to your computer, and you plug your mouse or keyboard or any other device into this Type-A port. This is the product page. It's likely you can just buy this directly from Adafruit or one of their distributors. The other board is the Waveshare RP2040 Pi Zero. It looks like this. It also has two USB ports, but both of them are Type-C. You use this one to connect it to your computer and use the other one to plug in your mouse or keyboard. The devices you will be plugging into it most likely have a Type-A plug, so you will probably need an adapter like this. You plug it into the USB-C port and then you can plug your mouse here. These adapters are cheap and widely available. Maybe you already have one for your phone. This is the product page for the Waveshare RP2040 Pi Zero. The board also has some other things like an SD card slot and an HDMI port, but HID Remapper currently doesn't use those. Okay, option 2 is to make your own HID Remapper using a Raspberry Pi Pico. Raspberry Pi Pico is a microcontroller board that looks like this. It's very cheap and widely available. Raspberry Pi are the makers of the RP2040 chip that is on all of these boards. In this case, they make both the chip and the board. If you've seen the project's GitHub repository, maybe you're aware that there are two variants of HID Remapper. One uses a single Pico board and the other uses two Pico boards. The difference is mostly compatibility. There are still some devices that don't work with the single Pico variant, though they aren't that common. Okay, let's say we're making an HID Remapper with a single Pico. This is what it will look like. This is just a USB extension cable that I cut in half, and I soldered the wires inside it to the right pins on the Pico. The details are all on the GitHub repository, but in this case it's very simple. D+, which is typically the green wire, goes to GPIO0. D-, which is typically the white wire, goes to GPIO1. Ground, which is typically black, goes to any of the grounds on the Pico. And VBUS, which is just a fancy name for 5 volts and is typically the red wire, goes to the VBUS pin on the Pico. And that's it. If you don't want to solder anything but still want to make this, you can try doing it with a breadboard and some jumper wires. You would need this USB Type-A breakout board with the pins already soldered in, and also the Pico with the pins already soldered in. If you can find that, then this is a valid no-soldering option of making the single Pico HID Remapper. Now, if you decide you want to make the dual Pico variant, it's the same deal. Either you solder some wires between the two boards. I won't list them all now, but it's all detailed on the GitHub repository. Or you can use a breadboard and jumper wires. Again, no soldering required for this option. Regardless regardless of how you make it, for the dual Pico variant, you're also going to need an OTG cable. It's a cable that has micro USB on one end and a female type A port on the other end. Again, they're cheap and available everywhere. Maybe you already have one for your phone. Okay, option 3 is where it gets interesting. These are all boards that I designed specifically for HID Remapper. Each has some unique features. For example, this one is just a dongle. You plug it directly into your computer. This one has a built-in 4-port USB hub. This one doesn't have any ports at all, but it's pretty small, so you can put it inside some device like a trackball, adding HID Remapper functionality to it without having an external adapter. This one has 18 3.5mm ports and can be used as an adaptive controller for your Nintendo Switch or your PC. The idea is that you can connect external buttons using these ports. It also has 4 USB inputs. Let's say one of these boards looks like something you would need. How would you go about getting one? There's a company in China called JLC PCB that manufactures PCBs for reasonable prices. The ordering process may be intimidating, but in reality, you don't have to know much about PCBs. On the GitHub repository for the HID Remapper project, for each of these boards, you will find the files that are required to make an order at JLC PCB. There are 3 files, and you just have to upload them to JLC PCB during the ordering process. First, you upload the Gerber file, which is for the PCB itself and all of its layers. All of this stuff you can just leave at the default values. One thing to note is that the minimum number of PCBs that you can order is 5. Then you enable PCB assembly. On one of the next screens, we will upload the 2 CSV files. BOM stands for Bill of Materials, and it's just a list of all of the components that we want to be soldered onto this board. CPL, nobody knows what it stands for, but it's for the pick and place machine. It lists the positions of all the components. Then it's just a matter of clicking through the rest of the screens. You don't really have to do anything here. Just pay attention and make sure all of the components are in stock. Eventually, you get to the part where you just check out, choose the shipping option, and give your payment information, just like you would on Amazon. No matter where you get your board from, before you can use it as an HID Remapper, you have to flash it with firmware. This is literally as simple as copying a file to a USB drive. You just have to know which file. There are different versions of the firmware for different boards. They're all listed on the GitHub repository. Also on the GitHub repository, you will find 3D models for the enclosures for most of these. If you have a 3D printer or have a friend with a 3D printer, you can print those. They're not strictly required, but they look nice and will maybe protect the board from damage. And that's it. I hope this is useful. Again, all the details are on the GitHub repository. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. Thanks for watching.